Units in measurement. Dear students, here are few things shown in the screen. Can you identify why these are used? You will definitely tell that the weighing machine is used to find the weight. The tape is used to find the length. And the clock is used to find the time. In short, these are used for measurement. Now, let us see another example. Here is a wire which is measured with the help of tape. The output of this measurement will be a number. This number is called the numerical measure. Now, consider that a weighing machine also gives some numerical value. Then, how you can differentiate between the two numerical measures? Here comes the term unit. A unit differentiates between the physical quantities. Unit. Dear students, measurement is important topic in physics. A unit is the relative comparison of the physical quantity with the internationally accepted reference standard. For example, unit of length is meter. Unit of weight is kilogram. Fundamental or base units. In nature, we find that there are large number of physical quantities. So, do we need separate unit for each physical quantity? The answer is no. It is because most of the physical quantities are interrelated. Thus, to express their units, we just need limited number of units. These are called the fundamental units. Some fundamental units are meter, kilogram, second, ampere, kelvin. Now we will see derived units. The units derived from fundamental units are called as derived units. For example, velocity is a physical quantity which can be expressed with the help of fundamental units meter and second and can be given as meter per second. Thus, meter per second is a derived unit. System of units. A complete set of fundamental units and derived units is called the system of units. We will discuss system of units in next topic.